To other news now, and there could be a judicial inquiry into the sale of the state's electricity assets, with claims a lack of competition will force power bills to skyrocket.
Eight power company directors quit in disgust overnight after seeing details of the sale.
Christina Keneally's found time to embrace celebrity this week, but the glamour has faded. Today, she let her treasurer do the talking on one of the state's most controversial deals, the electricity sell-off, and he was doing the hard sell.
That this is the best outcome for the people of New South Wales. It is an outstanding result, and the outcome for the people of New South Wales is very good.
But he was a lone voice. The $5.3 billion collected from the leasing deal has been panned, so much so, eight company directors resigned overnight in protest.
They've rammed it through in the middle of the night, appointing hand-picked people. It's just a disgrace. It makes no sense to replace a state monopoly with a private duopoly.
Origin Energy and True Energy are the two main beneficiaries, getting millions of state energy customers. Many fear dramatic price hikes.
People can't even pay the powers anymore, you know. I mean, they're going to make it even worse now.
Former Premier Bob Carr attempted privatisation in 1997. It was rejected by Labor, which he labels political idiocy. A clean-cut sale of retail and generation would have sunk $30 to $35 billion into the state's budget.
We've made sure it won't be Mr and Mrs New South Wales paying for future power stations to be built in this state.
The opposition has yet to reveal its plans for the state's energy sector, but this afternoon called on the Premier to establish a judicial inquiry into the bungled sell-off.
I think it stinks to high heaven. We need a judicial inquiry. We need to halt the process while that judicial inquiry is in place.
Josh Murphy, 10 News.